Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today I would like to share this new journal with you. And yeah, as you can see, it's a little bit like a monster. It has 11 signatures and so much stuff in it. It's the biggest journal I've ever made. And yeah, it tells my journey to Rome last November. And I would like to invite you to come with me to this journey through this journal. And I would like to give you some tips what you can do in the city. And yeah, this is more like an art journal or a mixed media journal, because I tried several things and visited many places of art in Rome. But it's a junk journal too, because all of the stuff I brought from the trip, so nearly all of the stuff, yeah, I will tell you something about where you can get things for your journals for free. And yeah, take a cup of coffee, perhaps. Sit down and come with me through this journal. On the outside, I used several things that maybe are interesting for you too. This little thing here, I took a stone. And this charm I bought on a market in Rome, and all these things are things that I collected during the trip. These little wooden letters I made with a laser engraver, and this band here is the original title of the book from where this cover comes. So this tells Between Heaven and Hell, and I think that's the perfect title for this trip, because yeah, it was between heaven and hell, because in this city there are so many things that are so beautiful and awesome, but there's also the hell. These little things I bought on a market too, also the closure of the book. And yeah, there are several things that I found there. This little charm here, I don't know if you believe that, but I found it on the street. And also this little thing here, it lives on the street. Yeah, so I took it home and now it is in my journal. So let's open it, but I think I have to take my coffee away. So it has this closure here. As I said, this is from a market in Rome, and these things are very, very cheap there. I think I had 6 or 7 of these closures for only 1 euro. Also, these little charms here, they are very cheap, and you can find, yeah, you can find things that you would never find in online shops or on Etsy or something like that. Yeah, I think you will see this during this journal trip. So on the front side here, I made a little band. Oh, this is from my shoe. This is the original band from my shoe that I wore during this trip. And it's a little bit special to me because this is 10 years old. And I had the same shoes on a trip to Rome 10 years ago. And yeah, Adidas is offensichtlich eine sehr gute Marke. So here I put some things that I couldn't glue into the journal, and I made a little holder, or how do you call that? This is a paper clip from a bottle cap that I found. That was a very special day, because yeah, we wanted to visit an art gallery, but we were on the wrong place, and I didn't recognize that until I looked to my city map. And then I was so angry, and I had to sit down and smoke a cigarette. And suddenly I recognized that there were many of these bottle caps on the ground. And so I decided to start to collect these things, because there are many different of them. You can find there all along, because yeah, the city is a little bit dirty, and so everyone throws his trash away, and yeah, you can find such things. Because of yeah, the thing that this is more than an art journal, I started with this photo. This is from a trash, how do you call that, a Mülltonne. I will put undertitles in this video because I can't explain everything in English. And it says art, so I took a photo and yeah, I glued this here to the first page because everything here is about art. And the little funny thing is that this says my real name, and I didn't recognize it when I collected this paper. This is from McDonald's, I think. And when I did these scraps, I thought, oh, my name here. And yeah, that was very funny for me. These are little sugar packets. I collected them because I don't like sugar in my coffee, but they are everywhere in every coffee bar, and you can get them for free. So yeah, these are empty. So I have a little glass of sugar now with all the sugar from these little packets, and I sewed them together. It's a little bit like a Franken page. Yeah. So now here comes this recycled paper. All these recycled papers you can see in this journal are from the restaurants we had our meals, and they lay on the tables, and onto them there are the plates, and yeah, afterwards your food. And yeah, why should they throw this away when you can take it and write your things down? So this one I wrote on the trip. But then I decided that is not such a good idea, because during the trip I didn't know how large this journal would be in the end. And yeah, when you write on it, then perhaps later on you have your text here into the spine, and that would not be very fine. So this is the bill, and a little paper from the train when you do seat reservation, you can get these things in the train, so have your eyes open. This is a little paper clip I made from this bottle cap. I can't remove it without my second hand. So I glued one of the bottle caps that I found on the ground to this little lace here, and on the background you see this paper clip, so that this little card from the restaurant, oopsala, this little card from the restaurant is a pocket, but this paper is too big, so I decided that this paper clip can hold everything in place. Yeah, the first coffee in Italy is, I think, the best coffee that you have in your life, because German coffee, and I think American coffee, and yeah, everywhere else, it's like brown water, and yeah, it's terrible. So this was in Verona, and we did a little stop there with the train, so we decided to drink a coffee there. And this is from a napkin that we got there. And this is a page that we did there too. It's not the coffee that you can see in this cup, but it's original Italian coffee. On the next page, I glued all the papers down that I had from the train trip. Yeah, this is from the parking space. We had to put this in our car to be allowed to park on the parking space during the time we were 2 weeks on this holiday. And yeah, this is from the woman from the hotel. She wrote this to an envelope, and we got our keys for the room in this envelope because the reception is not opened 24 hours. Yeah, then I wrote something down about the food we had there. This is spaghetti con cozze. It's for the German viewers. It's every time it's a little funny because Kotze in German, of course, it means something else and not such delicious things like you can see here on this plate. And then I added the little cards that I got in the restaurants, and everywhere where you can eat or drink, you get these little cards, and I think that's very nice because it's a very nice memory of this place. And yeah, when you like to do a journal with it, you can use it as a text, or yeah, you can make pockets from it, everything you want. This paper is also from this trip. I don't know if you can see that in my camera. It's from a modern art museum, and they had very large posters, I think you call it, like this. And I could do several pages for my journal from only one of these things. On the back side, there were informations of this art museum. And I decided to cover this up because, yeah, it's very difficult. You can't write on it. But I left some words here so that I remember what it was. And sometimes you have the number of the year here. And I think that's a bit cool. In Rome, there are very often these little cars, and they look so funny. If you see one of them, it looks so funny because the other cars are more bigger, and these little things are very slow and very loud, and the people in it are always looking very funny. So I took this photo when they all parked in this row, and yeah, that was a very funny moment for me. Then and some in some places of this journal, I had these little cards. These are the tickets for the metro bus. And the problem with this, to use this, is that it's thermo paper, so it reacts with heat. So normally this paper is white, and you have the black informations in a black color on it, but when you use this without heating it up, it will become as black as it is here within the time. And yeah, so I decided to take a heat gun, and I heated it up, and then it becomes black, as you can see here. A little bit white is left here, and then I took a white pen, this Uniball Signo broad pen. It's not my best friend, but for this text it works very well, and you can write on it and it wouldn't disappear with the time. So even if this gets black, yeah, the white pen wouldn't disappear, and you can read it after a time. So the next page is a little sentence from Johann Wolfgang von Goethe. And this one here is a page from my own printable. I decided to create a printable from my photos and my stuff. And you can find it also in my Etsy shop. I will show you some more pages because this is very blank, and I think I have to do something on it. I planned to make a pocket here, but because of this little mistake here, I don't know if you can see that. I'm not sure if I should do that, and this page is not ready. Then I think some of you will know this page. This is a pier, and yeah, as you can see, it is a pier, of course, but why is here a pier? I took this metal foil from a bottle from a drink that I had in Abbey Theatre. That's an Irish pub in Rome. And if you're interested to go there, I will link all the places I were and give you the correct address if you would like to visit it. And this is also from Abbey Theatre. This is also such a paper that was laying under our plates for food. Yeah, and this page, I'm not very happy with it, but I think, yeah, it fits to this restaurant that this page is so ugly. I hate it, but yeah, now it is here. This was my first try to do an urban sketch with watercolor, and I don't know how to do that. And I picked up a photo from Instagram because this restaurant is shown very, very often on Instagram, and I had no idea why. So I decided to go there, and yeah, we had a table here and we had food, and I thought, okay, what the hell is going on with this restaurant? I don't know. It was not so cheap. It was also, it was not expensive, but yeah, the food was food. And I don't know why there are so much people that photograph this restaurant. Perhaps you can go there, or perhaps you were there and you can tell me what's going on with this. I don't know. Yeah, this page, for this I took a little, it's like, how do you call that? I have to put an undertitle. I don't know how you call this. This is very thin paper, and it was in the in a little container where our fries were in. And the good thing on this is that the oil of the fries don't comes in this paper. So yeah, I glued it down here. This is from Abbey Pub too. And this says, art is everywhere. You only have to see it. And here I have a photo from a little stone wall, and there comes Rohr. Was ist denn jetzt wieder das Wort für Rohr? So this comes out here, and there's a little pig, and yeah, that was very funny because anyone ran across the street, and I think no one recognized this. And yeah. So this page of the Colosseum is from my printable too, and as you can see, I didn't cut this frame here. My printer can't print the printable to the edges of the paper, but because I have these white lines here, because the paper is not the same size everywhere, I decided to let this frame here. If you like to buy this printable, you of course can also cut this off or distress the edges. So yeah, on this page I decided to get some facts about the Colosseum, and I tried to write them down so that this whole page is full with this informations about the Colosseum. Oh yeah, this page is very special, and it was a restaurant that you can also see very often on photos on Instagram. I will also put a photo here in my video. And when you go along the street and you see this restaurant, I think you would first smell it. And it doesn't smell like food or pizza or I don't know. It smells like these flowers, and it's so incredible. You come to this restaurant and everywhere there are flowers. And yeah, it's so awesome. And the chef of this restaurant is the craziest man I ever met. He has such a cool style to dress. And he's so friendly. When you come in there, you have the feeling like you are in his living room. And yeah, you're welcome from the first second. And yeah, you, if you ever will be in Rome, you have to visit this restaurant. You can also press the stop button on your video and write this address down, but I will put it in the info box. This page, yeah, it was very dark, and I thought a long time about how I can manage this, because if you write here with a white pen and here with a white pen, you can't read it here anymore. But suddenly I had the idea that this looks a little bit like heaven. And this sentence says that Rome has as many girls like it has stars. So I punched out these little circles and did some stars. And yeah, for the rest I left it blank, because I wanted to have this. That's only also from such a restaurant table. And the story of this shit here, I'm a little bit afraid of telling you. So this building here, Leuchtturm, I don't know how to say it in English. You can see it when you are on the Gianicolo Hill. And I tried to paint it with coffee. I had a coffee there, and yeah, I had a little bit in my cup left. And I took this piece from a plant from the ground and tried to paint it. But it's a little bit difficult, because yeah, I can't paint these things, and it was just an experiment. And yeah, like so much things in here, it was yeah, just for fun. And then I found a little bookshop with very old books and papers. And I think if you ever have been there, you will find, I think you wouldn't find any other bookshop like this in the whole world. It was, yeah, you come in there and you have the feeling that you are in another world. And there were so much little papers, postcards and books and things where you think, how can this exist in our time? It has to be destroyed or thrown away, or I don't know. Yeah, this was a very, very special moment. And I bought a book there, and I asked the book shop owner if he had perhaps a children book in Italian language. And he jumped to a little regal, and yeah, he had the er hat sofort gewusst, wo er hinspringen muss, und plötzlich war er hinter seinem Tresen, und er hatte den totalen Durchblick. Das war komplett unglaublich. Then this page is about Lambrusco, my favorite drink for yeah, when I'm in Italy, even if it's not so hot, I like it very much. And these little tickets I made for my printable too. This is my homemade washi tape. I have also a tutorial video on my channel how to do this. Here's another Franken page from this sugar pockets. And yeah, this page, I had to do it because I was a little bit angry. I went to a coffee bar, and I ordered two coffee. And in Italy you say caffè when you mean espresso. And yeah, to I don't want it to be like a tourist, so I tried to order it right, and I said due caffè, and this barista said espresso, And I thought, am I an idiot or what's going on here? And so for this page, it's a little bit tricky to explain. I had a little picture of this Tower of Pisa. And here I wrote that if this happens to you, it's nearly the same thing as when you buy this Tower of Pisa in Rome on a souvenir shop. Yeah, I hope you can understand this joke. So it's a joke for me because, yeah, you don't want to be like a tourist when you are in Rome, and you try your very best. But yeah, in this coffee bar, it was not possible. So this was the first signature. And now here begins the second signature. It looks like here is nothing written, but when you have enough light, you can see that I wrote here with a golden pen, and I did this that you can't see it so clear because, yeah, it's a little story about a special place. I mean, the toilet, because toilet is a special theme for Rome. When you go to a toilet in Rome, you can be very, very happy when you open the door, if there is a door, and you find a toilet. I have seen toilet rooms in Rome where there was no toilet, and there even was no hole in the ground, so there was nothing. But yeah, a sign, this is the toilet. So you can be very happy when you have a door and a toilet. And yeah, you sit down and you are happy again because you have toilet paper. And yeah, then you recognize that something with your door is not correct. And yeah, after 10 seconds, another wife that has to go to toilet too comes to you. And yeah, it's not a very interesting special moment. So you... After you have recognized this, you have to close the door with your one hand and do everything what you have to do on the toilet with the other hand. That's not very easy. This page is a page from my printable 2. And I made this little pocket. This pocket you will get in the printable also. And here I have something from a paper shop. I will tell you later something about this incredible paper shop. And I cut it out and used it as Dink's journal card. This is from a coffee bar too. Little tag here. Yeah, this was, by the way, the original picture from the page I showed you before. This pocket is made from a paper from McDonald's. And then here, for the coffee discussion, I wrote something down about espresso and how it's made. Also a paper from this paper shop. And I tried to cover this hewing that I have on the other side here with these little red dots. So, yeah, that it looks like it has to be as it is here. During the trip, I used every chance to get those, yeah, I would call it stamps from coffee cups. In every coffee bar I were or restaurant, excuse me, I took the coffee cup after it was empty, left a little bit of coffee in it, and I I turned it upside down so that I got this original Italian coffee here in my book. If you like to do this, please use watercolor paper. This paper is from a book that I bought in Rome, and it's a very good quality. If you like to buy paper, buy it in Italy. So I never made this experience before because I thought my watercolor paper is good enough for me. And yeah, I never thought about it, but I found this little craft shop there and bought this paper, and it was amazing. I did some of these on a paper that I brought from home before I bought this book and before I found it. And yeah, you, if you can look at it in reality, yeah, you would see the difference between it. And it dries very fast when you do it on very good watercolor paper. It has not to be very thick, but it has to be good quality that you get those stamps here. Yeah, this was a first try for me to sketch a restaurant. I know it's not very realistic, but that was not the goal for this page for me, because I wanted to keep the memory and yeah, not painting a perfect urban sketch. And this was a restaurant called Triplo. And yeah, we found it because we decided to go to it because it says there would be on the roof, you can sit on the roof, like a roof terrace. I think that's the right word for it. And yeah, I expected that we can sit here on the roof of the restaurant with the sky above us, but that was not the reality, because yeah, we went up this very small stairs. It was very I don't know the word, and we come there, and yeah, there was a white roof above us. And yeah, I made a video about this page, there I tell you the whole story of this restaurant, because it was a little fail for the woman who worked there. I think she was very, very angry that we would like to sit on this third floor of this restaurant. But you can watch the whole video on my channel. I will do it here or here, or I don't know where it comes, and you can watch the story of this page. Then on several pages I wrote down some sentences from very famous people. This is again from Johann Wolfgang von Goethe, and put it my own memories here. Yeah, so we were in Rome in November, the end of November, and we found this very cute Christmas market on Piazza Mazzini, and we were in the bus all ready to go back to the hotel, and then I saw these lights, and I thought, what the hell is that? And I jumped out of the bus, and my boyfriend was a little bit shocked, because he had to jump out of the bus again also before the bus starts again to drive his way. And then we found this very, very cute Christmas market. And I think in Rome there are not it's not the city of Christmas markets, because yeah, you will find only a few of them that are like this, because this is not a tourist Christmas market. You will find some very special things, like you can see on the photos I will put in this video at this time. I think you can get very very much ideas for your crafting and new things that are, yeah, made in Italy and never known in other countries like America, Germany, Austria, or everywhere else. So this one is from a little coffee bar on Piazza Venezia. Yeah, if you like to go there, it's very it's a very cute bar, and you can yeah, you can see the Piazza Venezia and all the buildings around there. And I also stamped with coffee here and took this little napkin with me as a memory. And yeah, here's a little pocket. When we were in this museum from where this paper is, I had a very special moments with photograph artist, and yeah, on the backside from one of these posters there were some of his photos, and these are only two of them that yeah, that make you feel very yeah, I don't know the word for this, but I was so shocked because it's such a beautiful city and you go there for holiday and yeah, you see wonderful art and old buildings and everything, and then you see the reality of the world. And these photographs, they were in very big size there, in a dark room, and only a few light comes to these pictures, and yeah, it was the hell. So the title of my book is, as I said, Between Heaven and Hell, and for me this was the hell. There were children on these pictures, and also the adult people, the expressions in their faces, it was the hell for me. So I couldn't understand everything of these historical facts, but only the pictures were very, very shocking to me. This little pocket is from my printable 2. I used some photographs here, and all the things you can find in the printable are original photos that I took during the trip. And these are two tickets for the botanical garden, a very nice place too, but I think you should visit it in summer and not in November like we did. Yeah, this page is about one of my favorite buildings. It's about the Pantheon, and yeah, I have a funny story about this too, because I love this place in front of the Pantheon and the whole building, and yeah, the construction is very, very interesting. It would be a too long video if I would explain it, but I think you can read it on Wikipedia or Google Google it. But I was in Rome the first time. It was 1997, and I fell in love with the Pantheon. And as you can see on several souvenir shops, you will get those little buildings that you have in the city. This is a Colosseum, of course, and all this is made from marble, and yeah, you can find it everywhere, but you don't find a Pantheon. I thought in the whole city there's no little souvenir like this that shows the Pantheon. You will find the Tower of Pisa made from this marble, but no Pantheon. And in this year, so many years after my first trip there, this was my fourth time in Rome, my boyfriend, ta-da, found this little Pantheon, and it's so cute, and it's only €1. I know it would be not the best to buy this because everyone buys it, but yeah, I had to have it because it's the Pantheon. Yeah, I was very, very happy about it because, yeah, I waited so many years to get it. These little lights, I will show you the original picture in this video too, because I think you can't see it because of my light and the glossy paper of the photo. This was on the Christmas market on Piazza Mazzini too, and these were little balls with yeah, holes like mandala, and yeah, that was a very cute Dingsstand. Das sah sehr schön aus und es war sehr romantisch. And this sentence says, "Who has never seen Rome, don't know how beautiful life can be." And yeah, I wrote it to this whole page because it's so true. If you have never been there Perhaps you are thinking while you are watching this video, what the hell is this woman talking about? But if you think that, please go there and yeah, have these experiences I had there. Yeah, here are some coffee stamps too, a little ticket here that I heat gunned, and so that I can wrote on it and write on it. And this little paper clip, I am very proud of it. Let me show you. This looks not so spectacular, but oh, my camera. It moves around when you do like this, because this is a part from a bracelet, and there was a woman, a black woman with a little child on her back, and this child was sleeping, and this woman wanted to sell their bracelets, and nobody was there that who wants to buy something from her, because there are so many souvenir sellers in this city. On every place where you go, everywhere, they would come to you and talk to you, and they would like to yeah, sell you these things. And the best way, what you can do, the best thing that what you can do is to go your way and don't talk to them. And yeah, sometimes it would better to your money for the trip, because yeah, there are es gibt sehr viele Diebe dort, und gerade wenn man an Plätzen ist, wo sehr viele Menschen sind, dann sind diese Langfinger natürlich eine große Gefahr, und man kann sie sehr oft auch nicht von den ja, normalen Verkäufern unterscheiden, die diese Sachen verkaufen, um ihren Lebensunterhalt zu verdienen. And this wife was on our dining table, and I made the mistake that I looked at the child, and yeah, I had the problem that I have to give her some money, and she gave me this bracelet, and it was round, and I cut it up so that I could do this little paper clips here. Then you will find very, very much street art in Rome, and this is one of my favorite little street art things. It was on this green door, and I took this picture, and then I tried to do a little mixed media. This is a little bit like texture, but not so much. And yeah, I tried to follow the colors here that the original picture has. Oh, excuse me. And then this page looks a little bit dirty, because the problem was that my paint comes here to the other page, and these words I found on a wall, and I thought they would fit very good to this page, and I left it like it is, because this was original next to a graffiti that I found on a wall. And yeah, I think you have often the question, is it art or vandalism? And yeah, after a few minutes you think, okay, it's art. Not everything, but the most of these street art things and graffiti things are really, really beautiful and awesome. Yeah, here you see the next fail. This was an experiment to do a collage, and I'm not very happy with it, but now it's in here. And yeah, I made the mistake that I glued these scraps on the original page in the book after I sewed the signatures in. And I tried to collage a glass of beer, and it was a honey beer because of this, you see this little bee on the top. And yeah, let's go away from this. This is a photo from this photograph museum that I told you before. Yeah, and this was from the poster that I got from there too. This little tuck spot here is from my printable too. These are some flowers that I found on a market, and I changed their color. So yeah, I think it fits a little better to this rest of the colors. And in this restaurant, this was in Lido di Ostia, a little bit away from Rome, and we had a special moment there because we ordered two glasses of Coca-Cola but without ice. And this man in the restaurant, he was a little bit confused because, yeah, we were two people in this restaurant and he had lots of stress, and he couldn't imagine that we liked our glass of Coca-Cola without ice. And he came back with two glasses and two bottles of cola. And in these glasses, there were these little Eiswürfel. And we both looked at him and said, without ice, and he said, oh, excuse me. And I thought I wouldn't like that he has to go back and throw the ice away and come back with an empty glass, because we had we wanted our meal and we had we were very thirsty. And yeah, so I took the glass and made a little thing like this, and the ice flew away, and there was a tree, and yeah, all the ice was on the ground near the tree. And my boyfriend and this man from the restaurant laughed so much, and I thought her expression in her faces, it was yeah, he couldn't pay it with money. It was so funny. So this is from my printable too. For this one, I decided to do this black watercolor to the edges to let it come out a little bit more. I have to decide what to write here. Yeah, here's a blank page too. And so this is the third signature. And this was a very interesting museum too. I will give you the link in the info box. This is a modern art museum, and there are very, very much little but also well-known artists there, and everything is on the walls. And this building, it has been a sausage factory in a few times. You will see many of those, yeah, I think it's a little bit like mixed media on a wall. I think it's only paint here, but the structure of the wall and the roof and everything around makes it like you are walking through a very big mixed media journal, or yeah, something like that. So this is from a bag from Hard Rock Store, and I used it as a journaling card. This paper here in the background is also from my printable. Then here a picture about Piazza Navona, a very beautiful place when you visit it at night. At the day it's also beautiful, but yeah, I like it very much. At night there are very often there are musicians and some people who sell their art. You can buy watercolor pictures, but I think not every artist there is a true artist, because yeah, of this wegen dieser Problematik, dass es eben auch viele gibt, die Kopien von irgendwelchen Kunstdrucken verkaufen, und sie behaupten, das ist ihr eigenes Werk, aber das stimmt überhaupt gar nicht. Aber wenn man jetzt nicht ganz blöd ist, dann kann man das schon unterscheiden. In der Nacht ist es halt ein bisschen schwierig, muss man ein bisschen aufpassen, dass man dann nicht übers Ohr gehauen wird. some coffee stamping here. And this paper I bought in this paper shop I talked before too. This is a very cute little paper shop where you can get everything. I have never seen this before. I think most of you come from America who watched this video, and perhaps you have shops where you can get this, but I have never seen this before. This backside of the paper was blank, so I stamped here with yellow watercolor, but this is a very, very nice paper quality, and they have several of those there. And yeah, it looks like I have stamped here, but this was yeah, on the paper. And you can get everything there, and very big sizes. And the woman in the shop cutted this down to my size of book for me. And yeah, I thought that it was very friendly atmosphere there. Here, another bottle cap paper clip. You can like this. This is also one of those bottle caps I found there, and this little charm from the market. And here I have this little tag. This is my Rome printable too. That was a little sherry, but I don't I think that's not really a sherry, sondern eine Hagebutte. And she it was on the floor, and it was very wet. And yeah, it was there between the stones, and I thought that would be very pretty there. If you have very much money, then you can go to Rosati restaurant and drink a coffee there. It was incredibly expensive. It's directly near to Piazza del Popolo, and yeah, I don't think that this coffee was so awesome, or the food there is very special, so I would not go there a second time. But it was raining, and yeah, when it rains in Rome, it rains very, very much. And we sat down there to decide what we can do, how we can get back to the hotel, and we had a coffee there. And yeah, I thought, oh my god, where's my money? Yeah, this is from the little chocolate I got with my coffee, and I think that was the only highlight of this yeah, of this coffee, because I can do this little how do you call that thing here. This is the Colosseum at night. When you are ever in Rome, then please go at night to the Colosseum, or to the fountains, and every building you can imagine is so beautiful at night. And everywhere there are lights, and you have the feeling that it's not the same building that you saw during the day. So yeah, very, very special at night. Then here I have this little postcard, and I wrote something on the back side. This is in my printable too, and I did some stamping here. And this is from a restaurant. About that I wrote here. It's called Open Baladin. It's the same restaurant where I had this honey beer, where I did this terrible collage. That's from the same restaurant. And when you get the bill there, you get this little cute thing, and the bill is like this. And then you put your money here, and the woman from the restaurant comes and takes this away, and then you have to run very, very fast to get this back, because of course you can't go out of the restaurant without this. Yeah, and my boyfriend is very cute to me, and he ran after this woman, and so I got this this little thing here, like a paper clip. Also you can get this little card. This is a round card, and that was in this thing here too. Another little tag from my printable. And this page is about a very, very awesome, it's like Ausstellung, wenn ich doch bloß das englische Wort dafür könnte. Die Leute, die das hier angucken, die Deutsch sprechen, lachen sich wahrscheinlich zu Tode, aber ja, ich kann das nun mal nicht besser. This is about, this museum was about dreams, and it had the best audio guide I've ever heard. So you had to go through different rooms with some headphones, and the original artists from this museum, they told you the stories behind their art. And when I now think about it, it was so impressive and so real. You had the feeling that the artist is behind you and talks to you, and it was so good quality, and the stories behind those arts, they were fabulous. And it's about the theme, what's real? Is this life real, or are we only dreaming? Or what can we do to get a better life? And I can't explain this in English. It sounds terrible, but please go there when you are there. They are on Instagram too, and they will do several things like this with different themes in the future. And that was very great. So this little pocket I did like Linda Israel does her pockets. I saw a video from her, and she takes a piece of paper and folds it, and then you have different several of these pockets, and I have some tags that I can put here. And I decided to glue it, not the whole thing here, so that I have a pocket too for this little postcard. This picture is from this art museum in this sausage factory too. And I don't know if you can understand this, because this is a little tour, and the printing is on the wall behind. And I took this picture like this because I had the feeling that this woman is not very happy, and I tried to, I wanted her to be like in a, wie heißt denn das? In so einem Gefängnis. Mein Gott, nochmal. Fluchen sollte man vielleicht auch nicht. Vielleicht sagt der eine oder andere, den Kanal abonniere ich nicht. Okay, here, this is from a restaurant too, this paper. And you can see that they had this little face here on this paper for the tables. And it's their logo from the restaurant. And these cards, I like them very much because I like this color, and with the gold here, that was, I think that's just beautiful. Even if it's, obwohl es Werbung ist, ist es wunderschön, und ich habe es einfach mal mitgenommen und hinter dieses Foto gesteckt. This is a little metal foil from a bottle of wine. And it is a very nice color too, and I thought this golden color from here fits perfectly to the golden things of this card. I think in the video it's not so beautiful, but in reality it's amazing. And here I wrote something about this building, And yeah, of course you can read all these things in Wikipedia or Google. This page describes our visit to Gatsby Cafe. It was a tip of a woman who wrote some books about Rome, and she has some insider tips in it. And yeah, it was okay, and it was I think it was a nice place, but it was not so that I say I have to go there again. Yeah, I have two little cards here. This is from the Gatsby Cafe. You can see the address and little bus ticket here. This is from a city map that we got for free in the hotel. You very often get those maps in the hotels, or if you do a guided tour in Rome, you will get this. And yeah, it's very nice because it's paper and you can use it for your journal. Then we have these little rats here. This was on a street where yeah, I think young artists show their work, and I tried to yeah, get this memory in my book. So this is a page from my printable too. And yeah, it's very interesting to go by bus in Rome because it's an adventure every day. And I found this little fact about the bus driver in Rome. There are 6,500 bus drivers, and every day there are 970 that are at home because they are ill. So you have 2,300 buses in Rome, and every day there are 850 that are not driving. So you can imagine how full one bus is when you like to drive with the bus. Then this would be perhaps a little bit spooky that I have a page about French toast in my journal, but there is a very nice little restaurant called Coromandel. And they have the best French toast I ever had in my whole life. So, yeah, it was fantastic. And so I decided to write a recipe, how I can do this at home. And I wrote a little historical story about, yeah, this kind of food and where it comes from. So here's the next signature. And this is about this Coromandel restaurant. I did a little pocket here, and I found this cat on the wall and decided to try a little watercolor picture here. And yeah, that was very difficult because I didn't prepare this page and tried to paint with watercolor. And please don't do that. You will lose every nerve that you have because you can't see anything. If this paper is wet, it's all black, and you can't see where your real black paint is and where it's only wet. And you have to dry it and then paint again, and then dry it and paint again. And it's very difficult to do. So it would be better to put a little bit of gesso or other things to prepare this page. Yeah, this is the card from the restaurant. And this is the French toast I've been talking about. And it was so nice because they had so beautiful plates and cups. And yeah, it's just a beautiful place. And this coffee stamp is from this Coromandel restaurant, and my boyfriend did a little surprise for me because when I went to the toilet, he asked the woman of the restaurant to give their name here, and yeah, I was very happy because she was very friendly, and yeah, it's a very, very special restaurant. And the name of this restaurant is called Koromandel because the owner of this restaurant wanted to have a name, and she searched for the name, and then one morning she had her perfume, and she smelled, and yeah, she had the feeling that this is Koromandel, and she looked at the bottle and it says Koromandel, and that's the reason why this restaurant is called Koromandel. This little church is a very special thing too, because it doesn't fit in the rest of the area, and yeah, unfortunately it was closed when we were there, and yeah, so we could only visit it from the outside. And here in this little circles I wrote some facts about it. Yeah, this is the entrance of this sausage factory museum, and there were very, very many letterboxes, and I think it's very helpful to know that the entrance is looking like this, because you would never find this museum when you don't know that it is behind this wall. An interesting fact about this is that you can go there for free, but if you will go through this door, you will find an old woman sitting here on the right side, and she says that the entrance is €2, and yeah, it's one of those poor people that have no chance in their life, and they try to get some money, and I think it's good when you give her something, because there are not so many people, and I think she is sitting there the whole day, and yeah, she has a very big problem with money, and so I decided to give her something. And there's also a little piece of hell in this museum, because I think there are some people, they have to live there. I don't have a photo of that, because it was so terrible, and I couldn't bring my heart to take a picture of this. On the right side you can go in this direction, and there are clothes hanging outside, and yeah, bottles of beer and little tables, and yeah, but aber es ist so heruntergekommen und so schrecklich, und ja, es riecht unglaublich da. Ich habe das vorher nicht gewusst, dass es sich hierbei um eine ehemalige Wurstfabrik handelt. Das habe ich erst im Nachhinein herausgefunden, aber der Gestank in diesem Museum ist unerträglich. Also du musst dich schon wirklich dafür interessieren, wenn du dahin gehen willst. Es ist wirklich sehr eindrucksvoll, aber ja, es ist auch irgendwie ziemlich grauselig, diese Leute da zu sehen, und eine Unmenge an Katzen, die dort durch die Gegend schwirren. Ich meine, das ist ja natürlich in Rom öfters mal der Fall, aber ja, das war schon ziemlich krass. Als wir hier hingekommen sind, standen hier so merkwürdige Gestalten vor dieser Tür, und ich habe mich zuerst gar nicht getraut, da entlang zu gehen. Komischerweise waren die dann auf einmal total freundlich. Ich habe zuerst gedacht, die bringen mich jetzt gleich um oder irgendwas, wenn ich da jetzt durch diese Tür gehe. Aber komischerweise waren die mega freundlich, und auch die Leute da drin waren irgendwie total so interessiert, und ja, die haben sich da irgendwie gegrüßt, was man ja normalerweise gar nicht so macht, weil ja, Rom, viele Leute und so, grüßt man sich ja eigentlich jetzt nicht. Aber ja, das war das. And if you like a typical Italian sweet thing, I think you have to go to Zum Tiramisu. They say in all the city guides that it's the best tiramisu you can get in the world. And I think I'm a tiramisu expert, and it is the best. So this is a picture. of this tiramisu and 2 cups of coffee. And the interesting thing is that you first think, huh? Why am I getting my coffee and my tiramisu in this paper Dings? Das ist aus Pappe. Und dieser Becher ist auch aus Pappe. Warum bekomme ich das nicht in einem Glas oder irgendwas? Everything in this restaurant is recyclable. And yeah, they don't waste those dishes. And yeah, I think also the napkins are made from recycled paper. This is a part of this napkin. I try to glue it down here, but the color has lost somewhere in the underground. I don't know. I don't know where it is now, but yeah, this napkin was brown and now it's, yeah, like a little piece of shit. Yeah, this is called Zoom tiramisu because you need sugar, eggs and mascarpone to do a tiramisu. And so they took the first letters from these Italian words to build the name. And this is from the restaurant too. So I made a little tuck spot here. This is also from a bus ticket. And yeah, little pocket here. And this is also a page from a printable, and I wrote with this white letter here this sentence, every street is going to Rome, or I don't know if this is the right translation for it. Here are two of the pictures of this very impressive photo museum. And these are the tickets for this museum. I think this is a very special thing because not all of the tickets are so colorful. And sometimes you have to ask to get your tickets back. So this, you can see, it's folded here. And on the left side here was another ticket. But yeah, they... Sie haben es hier abgerissen und dann haben die uns das weggenommen und wir haben es nicht mehr wieder zurückbekommen. Sehr ärgerlich. Aber naja. Geht das jetzt hier nicht rein? yeah. This is about the Engelsburg. Some facts about this. And yeah, I had a postcard. And I... that was only from... place where I haven't been, so I cut it up so that I only have this this backside. No, not backside. This how do you call that? This little piece of thing here. Yeah. Yeah, this is a Franken page, mixed media, something like that experiment. I have an extra video on my channel how I did this, so I will link it below and you can see how I did this. These are sugar bags too. Then this page is about the place in front of the Pantheon, and I also wrote some facts about it and yeah, added the photos that I took there. This is from my printable too. This is a water clock, and yeah, it's on the Pincio Hill, and that's very interesting. I think you have to see this in real, in reality, because this clock only works with water. And this park around it is very, very beautiful. And yeah, you can sit there and have a break, and it's very nice. And that was the funniest and curiosest story ever. I was sitting on a little bank in this park, and then I saw that there is this wood from the trees everywhere on the ground, but because of the rain it was very wet and not so fine to take it away. So I said, I would like to have such piece of wood for my junk journal. And in the same moment, this piece of wood fell from this tree, and it fell directly on my leg. And so I had this. It was like the tree had heard me. In some coffee bars, I made this coffee stamp I showed you before, and when I liked it, when it was a special coffee bar, I wrote something about it, like here. And yeah, this is a page about Chianti wine, and I tried to do this little watercolor thing here, because the Chianti wine has this red cock as symbol on the bottles of the wine. And I wrote something from Wikipedia here, so because I wanted this journal to be something like a special city guide for myself. And so I wrote very much about the things you can get in Rome. And yeah, Chianti is not a special wine for Rome, it's from the Toscana, but you get it there when you when you are a tourist, you will get Chianti in Rome. So another page with this coffee stamps. And the only thing I did in the correct order are these pages with the stamps. So you can see I wrote the date when I stamped this, and the name of the coffee bar, and some notes, or the street where it was. And these are the only pages that are in order of the trip. The last year I was in Rome too. I think if you know my channel, you know that there is a flip through of my Rome journal from the last year. There I did everything in the right order, but as you can see, this is so much material that I decided to make it more like a topic themed journal. I don't know how to say this. I tried to find a special ice cream. I had another ice cream because this ice cream I couldn't find in the city anymore. And I made this little thing here to hold this Löffel. Mein Gott, ich bin schon ganz blöd im Kopf. Keine Ahnung, wie das heißt. This is a page about cacio e pepe. It's a very traditional meal with a special pasta and cheese and pepper. And it's a historical, some historical facts about this meal, and I like it very, very much. But there are only, I think, a few places where you can eat this, because it has become a little bit like a tourist menu. And I think the quality is not everywhere the same. So I will link some addresses in the info box when you like, if you like to taste this, where I think you get the best cacio e pepe. And this is another experiment with watercolor where I tried to paint this croissant, and it's a typical thing for Italian people that they don't have a very big breakfast. They go to a coffee bar, and yeah, I think they ran into a coffee bar because they have no time, they have to go to work, and they just drink a cup of coffee, and sometimes they eat these little things, and you can get those with vanilla cream or chocolate, or my favorite thing is pistachio. I don't know the English word. And yeah, this says it's every day the same question, which of these croissants do you like? And I tried them, and yeah, for me, it's my favorite is this pistachio cream. And I found a store where you can get this cream online. Yeah, it's based on white chocolate with these pistachio nuts in it. And yeah, one of those little glasses, it's 10 euro, but it's fantastic. And yeah, it will never be the same when you eat this at home, but yeah, a little memory to this fantastic breakfast. This is a Frankenpage from Sugarbags again. Again, a little coffee paper here from this paper shop. Some pockets here. This is a double pocket. This is from my printable too. You can put something in here, like this postcard, and something in front. And then we found a special meal that is called arancini. I don't know in English. Arancini. These are little rice and vegetable or meat filled balls, and it's a little bit bigger than these zupli balls that you can get there, but they are very delicious, and it's tradition from Sicilia. Yeah, so we tasted them, and I tried to draw them here on this paper. It was a very yeah, hard thing because of the structure of the paper, because I haven't prepared it, and yeah, but for me it's okay. Then for the first time in my life I was in the Hard Rock store. You can see some labels from a t-shirt that I bought there, and the strange thing about this was I've never been to a Hard Rock cafe before, so I bought this t-shirt in the shop because I liked it very much, and then I decided I have to go to this Hard Rock cafe because I can't wear a Hard Rock t-shirt when I have never been in this cafe. So I walked 3 kilometers from the store to the cafe, and yeah, I will show you later another page about the Hard Rock cafe, and there were so many people. It was, yeah, very, very full there. Another traditional meal that you will get is Fiori di Zucca. Zucker, ja, wenn man nur Deutsch sprechen kann und eigentlich keine andere Sprache, ist man schon irgendwie ziemlich am Arsch. These flowers from the pumpkin, you get, they are cooked in oil, frittiert, fried, wie sagt man da, and they are a little... Yeah, these little flowers, mostly you get two or three of them, and they are very delicious. I would like to try this at home. I don't know if that is possible, but here I wrote a recipe about this meal. Yeah, again, a little napkin, and you can fold this out here. So I glued this bus ticket where we what we use to get to this coffee bar, and another little pocket and a journaling card here. So the next station that could be very interesting for art lovers is the Mercato Monti. It's an urban market, and this is the flyer from this market. You have the informations when the dates when it's open, and all these cards are from artists that were showing their jewelry, and they had some paper crafts and shoes, everything, little dolls, China dolls. It was a China look. This is Piazza Navona. This is a picture from a street art museum. It's not really a museum in a building or something like that, but all these pictures you can find in this Muro Street Art Museum are on the walls of some buildings, and you can walk through the streets and find them by yourself, or you can book a tour with a guide. We did it by our own, and it was very interesting because it was a little bit like Schnitzeljagd. then there's another special thing to eat. It's called Maritozzi, and I wrote also the recipe here, but I think you can't do it at home like they do it in Italy, because it's so fantastic. It's a little Bun, ist das das richtige Wort? So ein kleines Hefebrötchen, und da drin, was ist das denn hier für eine Scheiße? Das sollte man auch nicht machen, das mit Washi-Tape zusammenkleben. Don't use Washi-Tape to put two pages together. I hate Washi-Tape for the rest of my life. I have to say this. Every producer of Washi-Tape, don't meet me, because that's a really shitty thing to get those pages together. Back to Maritozzi. Maritozzi are those little filled things. There's vanilla cream in it, and they are very, very great. Here's a little fact about the Trevi Fountain. There's a little story that when you throw a coin into this fountain, that you will get back to Rome. And I think in 1997 I threw a coin, and I came back, but the times after that I didn't do it, and I came back to the city trotzdem. And what I was shocked about is that every year there are 1.5 million euro that are laying in this fountain. Lasst euch das auf der Zunge zergehen. Das ist so krass. Also das, rechnet ihr das mal bitte auf den Tag aus. Die Leute haben sehr viel Geld. Okay, this is the place of St. Peter. And in this year there was, this was Christmas time of course, and there was a sand building of the birth of Jesus. And I wrote something about the sand and where it comes from. And they had this Christmas tree already here. I think you can't see this. And unfortunately, we can't see how they build up this this sand sculpture. But I found some pictures afterwards in the internet. And here was a barrier, and they worked there on the day, and there were so many people, and we unfortunately couldn't see it, but yeah, very impressive that they built it from sand. And I wrote here, what would they take in the next year? Perhaps sugar, because it was so strange. You will meet many, many cats in Rome. And yeah, this was like a little art piece for me, because this cat was sitting on this motorcycle, and this graffiti in the background, that was very nice for me. This is from a wine bottle too. You can get those little tags for free, of course, when you order a bottle of wine. You can take this for your journal. And this is, yeah, I think my favorite street art picture. I couldn't take a really good picture because of this shabby car here. yeah, but I like this so much. She's so beautiful. And the next experiment I would like to do is to paint a copy by myself of her. And yeah, it's very cool. Again, a little paperclip from this bracelet. And this sentence, "Karma is a bitch," I found in this dream museum. And yeah, I think it's very true. This is from my printable too. Then I made this pasta page. I wrote all the names of pasta I know here, and a recipe about green pesto. It's one of my favorite things to have on pasta. And one for red pesto, so that yeah, I have all these recipes here that I can do my own at home. Some coffee stamping here. And all these little tags I cut it up from, cut it out from things I got there. And yeah, wrote something on it. Sometimes you will get those glossy cardstock, and a very good pen for this is this Korrekturstift. It's a very cheap pen that you can get in a dollar store, and it's normally used for correcting things. So when you wrote something that's not correct, you can write over it, and it writes very, very fast, and then you can write the right word over it. But I often use it to do such things that are very thick, and with this Uniball pen, it would last it would take very long to fill this up. So yeah, and it's much cheaper than the Uniball pen. Yeah, some photos I glued so that I have a little pocket like this one, or it's yeah, more than a very big belly band. Then this page is about the Bocca della Verità, the try of painting of it. And yeah, as always, very, very hard. I prepared this page with a homemade gesso, but it was very hard to get this print, this painting on it. Here is a little paper from Burger King. I think it's not a very normal thing to go to Burger King when you are in Rome. But when we were in this museum that's in this sausage factory, there was this bad smell, and the streets around it were so ugly and terrible, that we decided that the only place, safe place, where we can have a meal is Burger King. So I took this paper from the tablet that you got there, and I had to put it in here because, yeah, it's a bad memory, but it's a memory. And this page, yeah, this was an accident. I tried to paint a mandala with white and golden pen here. And then I found that it's so terrible, and then I decided to stamp over it. So the blue and white paint that you can see here, these little dots, I only stamped over it with a little stencil from an orange package. Yeah, here's this little charm that I have from the street. I told you my boyfriend found this on the street, and I added this this paper clip and a little piece of this bracelet from this poor woman. And this mixed media page is about bus driving in Rome. I have a video on my channel how I did this, so I will link it and you can watch it. This is a page about Lido di Ostia. We went to this little town, and I glued these sea glass that I found on the Strand, beach. And that was very interesting. I have much more of those little founds, and this one, it looks like a chewing gum, but it's a sea glass. And in the last year, I had lots of those little yellow stones in my bag after we visited this beach. And in this year, those two were the only ones I could find, and there were so many other shells and something like those sea glasses that I haven't seen in the last year. And yeah, it's nature. It's incredible, but yeah, you will find very cute things that you can use in your journal. And for this flower, I used a little tiny Schneckenhaus. Don't know if you can see that. Here's a little journaling card. Yeah, and then here's this little mouse. And this was a very strange thing too, because I had to go to the toilet in a coffee bar. And I sat there, and yeah, what you do on this toilet. And there was no light, and suddenly there was a mouse on the floor. And I screamed, but I was so shocked. But I like mice, but yeah, I didn't expect it in this coffee bar, because yeah, hygienische Zustände und so, aber sowas ist auch in Rom wohl irgendwie normal. Then we saw on the street art tour a little atelier from a woman, Roberta Sanges is her name, and yeah, look at this. I took a photo from this wall there, and I think it looks like, yeah, like a collage, mixed media, yeah, a piece of art on the wall. It was really incredible. And on another wall, she had this sentence. It was just written with a black paint. I'm just a station in your way. And I think for me, she's not right, because I will never forget that. On the whole street, there were things like these dolls, and yeah, the whole walls were painted, but not like ugly graffiti. A little bit it looks like here on this picture, but when you see it in the whole when you see the whole wall, you wouldn't believe it. It's incredible. There were little tiny pigs and mice and those pupils here, and yeah, she painted everything. There were a Barbie doll with so big breasts. Yeah, Steel Panther would be happy about these boobies, but no real woman would. Keine vernünftige existierende Frau könnte mit diesen dicken Dingern laufen, aber es hat halt einfach irgendwie total strange ausgesehen. Yeah, this little garden gnome I found in this shop, Costura Concept Store, and there was an this artist gallery exhibition. Sagt man das? I have a video on my channel how I did this with watercolor, and this is a city map, and this is also a little pocket here. For some places, I only have made such a watercolor page with some stamping, and then wrote the name of this building or fountain or yeah, whatever. And this is a little, yeah, like a belly band too. You can, I have to pick up a paper. You can put this like this. It's a little bit, yeah, round. But this is the rest of the bracelet I bought from this woman. And perhaps you can see this. I try to lift it up. There, I added a little stone that I found somewhere on the ground. I think it was on the Gianicolo Hill. And the bracelet has this little silver pearls. They were there when I bought it. As you can see, they move around a little bit. And then I took a little tool from my garage and yeah, made it a little bit bigger so that I can add this stone here. And yeah, so this is a good possibility with this thing to add things that you normally couldn't add to your journal, because I yeah, didn't know how to glue this to a page, so I decided to go this way. This is from the Muro Street Art Tour 2. Another pocket here. And this page is dedicated to the best sushi I ever had in my life. It was at this restaurant, Santa Clarita, in a special market. And it's called Mercato Testaccio. And yeah, they had this little cat that moves her arm the whole day. I think you know these China cats. Normally they are golden, but because of this page that's white, I decided to draw a white cat. And yeah, this was the first time for me to do this circle with watercolor leaves. Yeah, I think for the first time it's okay. But this sushi was so fantastic. So if you are ever there, please go there and taste it. It's incredible. And this page is not ready until yet, because I have a little problem with it. These numbers are the door code that you need to get to our hotel. It's called Residenza Domizia. So if you need a cheap hotel, so that's in the center of Rome, please choose Residenza Domizia. It's a fantastic hotel, and they are very friendly there. You can come there rund um die Uhr, 24 hours a day. And yeah, so when you do a city tour, you have to go very often to your hotel and back, and yeah, you need this code, and it's lasered in my brain, so I wanted to have it here in my journal. This picture is from, oopsala, this picture is from a restaurant with a very big wine card. It was like a Bible, and yeah, my boyfriend said, so I have to tell you, this picture was hanging on the wall behind me, and I haven't seen it until my boyfriend said, please give me your smartphone, I would like to take a picture of you. And he took my smartphone, and I'm an idiot, and I didn't check what he would do. And yeah, so he took the picture of this woman, and yeah, the man from the restaurant laughed very much. Me not, but yeah, I think it's a nice vintage woman. And I glued some napkins that I got from another restaurant here with a little golden structure paste here. This is from the Dream Museum too. It's a whole room that is doodled like this, and yeah, if you like doodling, you can learn a lot only when you walk through this room. A little some little facts about mozzarella. And this is a very nice restaurant. They had this typical yeah, menu card outside. You will find those chalk written signs everywhere in Rome. And we were there the last year, so we decided to go there another time. It's called Damasi, and it's very traditional, and yeah, no tourist menu. And it's very, very good restaurant. So, yeah, this is a page where I have a video too. You can see that my journal is so thick that you can't see the whole picture. But I have a video on my channel where I show you how I did this mixed media page. And this was, I think, my second try to draw a face. And, yeah, do it in this mixed media style. And this woman reminds me a bit of this woman with the bracelets and the child on her back. And sometimes you will find funny things on the ground. This was a very, very tiny egg. I think it's one of those sweet eggs that you, ja, so wie Gummibärchen. Aber es war so verregnet und es hat ein bisschen lustig ausgesehen. Und dann habe ich gesagt, oh, guck mal, ein Spiegelei. Ja, so war das. Some facts about the Fountain of Boccaccia. I don't know if it's called like this. It's in the near of the Spanish Steps. Another pocket where you have much space to put something in. And another photo of this dream art museum. Another postcard. This is also from my printable. And then my sulky frog. Another mixed media experiment that I never did before. I had those strings from a bag, and I used those strings for the arms. And this frog I found in this urban market as yeah, as a cute little frog doll. Don't know if you can call that like this. And I tried to imitate it and do my own interpretation of this photo. I did that very often, that I looked at my photos and yeah, I thought about how can I do my own interpretation for this journal, because there are so many photos, and I didn't want to print out every photo because, yeah, it's for me, it's an art journey. It has been an art journey to make this journal. And so I tried out some things like mixed media things and drawing eyes that I never did before. So I decided not to take the photo, but to do my own interpretation of this things that I saw there. This is a page about the cats in Rome. And my light is very bad here. I tried to draw this little cat here, and the background is from my printable too, and this is a structure from a very, very old building that I photographed it, and I tried to use these ornaments for the cat. So I don't know if you can imagine where this has to be. So that this is this is like a little mandala, and it's completed with the body of the cat, or here in the head. And when I draw this, suddenly in the structure of this of this wall, I saw this little butterfly here, and I decided to do the nose of the cat like this butterfly. I hope you can see that. So that was one of the first times that I tried to shade and how do you call this? Diese Übergänge da mit Buntstift. Yeah, in this restaurant with the honey beer, Open Baladin, the city guide told me that there are the best burgers that you, one of the best burger restaurant in Rome. And I ordered the Pink Panther, and they said it's special for vegetarian or vegan people. And I thought I had a stone on my plate. It was the one of the terrible, most terrible food that I ever had in Italy, and especially in Rome. It was terrible. So if you like to eat a burger, please go to Trinity College or to Mons Angels. It's very, very better place, but this was it was the hell. About this little collage page, I have an extra video on my channel too. There I show you how I made these little paper flowers. Now they are very flat, because when you close the book, they get very flat, but normally you can lift up those leaves here, and it looks a little bit strange now, but that's the destiny when you close up your book, when you close your book. This little sentence I liked very much. I found it on one of the stores. It says, "Merry everything and a happy always." So it was Christmas time, and they wrote this on the store window, and I thought that would fit very cool to a special Christmas card when you make a card for your friends or your family, and then you can use this, and it's a little bit more special than these typical Christmas wishes that you can find on cards. Little pocket here. This is from a flyer that I got somewhere in a coffee bar. We haven't been to this museum, so I covered the front so that I can use it for something else, and I will cover the back side so that I can journal on it later. This is one of the Muro street art pictures too. And this little sentence, coffee is the balm of the heart and the spirit, I found on a little box where sugar was, where there was sugar in it, and on this little box there was this sentence. And if you like to have many special things in your journal when you do a trip to Rome or any other city, I think you have you need to have very open eyes, because I think nobody else had seen this from the people who were sitting there with me in this coffee bar. And I think when you do journals, art journals or mixed media journals or junk journals, you have these open eyes and you will see those little things that you that will perfectly fit to your journal later. Yeah, this is the page about the Hard Rock Cafe, where I went after I bought this t-shirt, and I decided to make this Violinschlüssel, don't know the English word, and I stamped these little buildings with little things from a children play, children game, and then I doodled these, yeah, these details. But I have a video on my channel too. So if you like to have a really good burger, you can go to Hard Rock Cafe too. But if you like to sit on a table, please call them, and you have to say that you want a table. Otherwise, you can wait at the bar. When there's a free place, you can eat at the bar too. And we did that because there were so many people, and it was so crowded and full of people who wanted to eat there. And yeah, I don't know if I'm too stupid to understand that, but I think it's a normal restaurant. Only the thing that there is, yeah, that it's a Hard Rock Cafe. I think it's not such a special thing where you have to go, but some people like to collect these Hard Rock t-shirts or something like that. This is from the burger. And yeah, then when you are a collector and Hard Rock fan, then you have to go there, of course. Another really cool place for street art is Tor Marancia. I don't know if I say that in the correct way, because I'm not Italian. And there are very big street art pictures that you can find there, like this one or this one. This is a really awesome collage, and this is a whole house where yeah, people live in, and it's 1, 2, 3, 4 floors, and it's yeah, very amazing to see these big pieces of art on the walls of the houses. And there are, I think, round about 12 or 15 of these art pieces in this area. This is from this Tor Marancia street art too, one of those buildings. And for the German viewers, guckt euch bitte das an. Achtung Banditen. Nur weil die Italiener kein Ü in ihrer Sprache zur Verfügung haben, beziehungsweise in ihrem Alphabet, hat wohl hier eine kleine Übergeneralisierung stattgefunden, und ich habe gedacht, ich mache Pipi in meine Hose, als ich das gesehen habe. Ich musste das unbedingt fotografieren, weil ich es dermaßen lustig gefunden habe, und auch noch in Kombination mit diesem Kaktus da oben. Sehr geil. This is one of the yeah, one of these houses too. And yeah, when I looked at this picture, I asked myself if they took this house and turned it round so that the artist can draw this girl, because it looks like he did it with a string. I don't know if you know these YouTube videos where they paint with kids and they only use strings and black paint. And that's really amazing that with such little, yeah, black lines, there can be this woman on this wall. That's one of my favorite street art pictures. Those two little cute birds were in the park of the Villa Tolonia and Casetta della Civette. I think it's called like this. And this little parrot tried to get in a little friendship with this dove, but the dove thought, I'm sure the dove thought, what the fuck is this little parrot doing there? I have a video on my channel about this page too. And yeah, I tried a little experiment to do a low budget structure paste here, like white gesso, but it's only acrylic paint and glue. And this is only normal children watercolor. If you like, you can check out the video. There you can see how I did this with nearly no budget. This page is from my printable 2 that you can get in my Etsy shop. It's another little paperclip with this charm that I found on this special market that I told you before. This is from the Dream Museum. This was a whole room with those golden, yeah, like coins, and it looked so strange and like from another planet. It's just, that was very, very impressive. Two little tags. This stone link card is a little bit empty. And this picture I found on a wall near our hotel, and I tried to imitate it, and I think everyone who knows where this is will recognize that it is this. Yeah, I think it was a good job. For this I prepared the page, so it was more easy to draw on it. And sometimes when I did those coffee stamps, I blowed them that they yeah, that this coffee flies away. And I think this looks like a little flower here. And yeah, so not every stamp from this coffee is the same. Then this is a page about the Mura Museum. It tells the story about the historical city wall, and yeah, you can find very interesting informations about the story of the city wall, and you can go up and you have a beautiful view over the whole city. Okay, this is, I think, a fail too, because I tried to sketch this building. I will put an original photo of it in the video so that you can see what I wanted to do. But my paper was a little bit, I think it soaked the watercolor, and everything was suddenly so dark, and I couldn't do any shading anymore. And yeah, I don't know what to do with this page, so I didn't write anything about this building here, because I don't know what to do with it. Perhaps you have an idea. Yes, I can tear it out, but then everything will fall apart, and that's not so good. So if you have an idea, please leave a comment. Perhaps, yeah, somebody else has an idea what to do with it. This is from my printable too. Normally this is a double page sheet, but I didn't use it in the journal because I had so much paper from the restaurants, because you have seen all of those papers are from those restaurants. And sometimes I thought my own pages would be too much, and so I took only the scrap and glued it down here, and I like to write something about St. Peter here. Some street art here. Yeah, and this is from the flyer of this artist in this Costura concept store, and that was incredible. You go in this store and you can buy clothes and everything there, and at the same time you have this beautiful art on the wall, and this was from a flyer where the artist is wo die Künstlerin sich vorgestellt hat, und ich war ganz begeistert, dass man das mitnehmen durfte, also habe ich das hier mal benutzt. Another little charm here. This is a collage page. I have a video for this, a process video for this page too on my channel. So if you like to know how I did this, you can click the video. Yeah, this is a very, very famous street art picture. I think if you like Rome, you have seen this before. I expected that this girl would be much bigger than she is in reality, but she's so cute, and the expression in her face, I think it's a very big talent who did this. These are those little Mariotti sweet things. And this is from a wall of a artist who works with wood, and he did those little arrows that you know where are the most favorite places. And yeah, I try to imitate that for my journal here. This is from my printable too. Yeah, this page is a memory of the day I bought this little silver ring, and I did this Om symbol here to the page in memory of this ring. Then this is a picture of the Colosseum, of course, and here I wrote something that I happened to me there. There was a guided tour, and there were some people, and it was an English tour, so I could understand something that the guide was talking about. And he told something about the little fountains of Rome. Every of those little fountains are there you can get water that you can drink, and they have a little second hole in the on top, and if you press there you can the water will come out, like es spritzt dann da oben so raus, und dann kannst du da draus trinken, ohne dich großartig anzustrengen. And I had to try it out, and I was very happy that nobody got wet, because the water comes out very, very high and very much water, and that was very funny. What you also have to try when you are in Rome are those maronis, castanien. You get them, I think, everywhere, and every time in the year. And they are very, very good. A little bit expensive, but I think, you can spend your money, because it's very delicious. Then I found those little leaves from a tree, and those brown ones were on the ground, and the purple ones I collected from the tree, and I glued them here with bookbinding glue, and then I added a layer of homemade gesso, so yeah, they will stay here forever, I think. This sentence, so many things are left unsaid and birds that cannot fly are dead, I found in the restaurant Mons Angels, and yeah, it was written on the wall, and I decided to try yeah, this whimsy girl face, and yeah, this is one of my first tries to draw a face, and for this page I have a process video too. Then sometimes you will find some things that you can't understand. This is yeah, a little Christmas decoration from a store that is on the right side here that you can't see in this photo, and this is a part of a Baugerüst, was direkt daneben gestanden ist. And yeah, I think there's the question: is it only a wrong placed Baugerüst, or is it art? For me, this picture is art because, yeah, the colors fit together, and yeah, I thought it's worth to take a picture. This woman reminds me a little bit of this art that I found in this concept store, and I tried to draw her with a normal black pen, and then I spritzed water, but I have a process video of this page too, so if you like to check it out, click the link. This photo I took on the first day of our trip when we arrived at the Termini station, and it reminds me a little bit to washi tape. You know, washi tape is not my best friend, but I thought, yeah, it was glued on the floor so that you know in which direction you have to go to get a taxi. And yeah, I had to take this picture. My boyfriend wants to go to the hotel, but he had to stop with me because I can't go without taking this picture. This is from my printable too. There's a little pocket you can glue here by yourself. Then I found this little bird. I made a pocket here. For this page I have a process video too, how I did those little flowers and birds. These are two bus tickets, and here you can see how this normally looks. And as I mentioned, I took a heat gun and heated it up, and I will show you here what will happen. It takes a little time and it's very hot. But as you can see, with a little time and yeah, with a very hot heat gun like this, you can create this marbled black effect, and then you can, when you heat it up the whole surface, you can write on it with a white pen, as I showed you before. So Yeah, that's a cute way, I think, to use those tickets, because you have very many of those tickets when you go to a city like Rome, because you take the bus or the metro every day, and then you have tons of those. A little pocket here, where you can put something in. This is from this book I bought in this antique bookshop. This washi tape is not very good gluing to this recycled paper, but yeah. Yeah, this is my little Mrs. Julia. This was the first attempt to try to draw a mixed media girl, and this was from a coffee bar where they had these oranges on this table in front of the coffee bar, and so I decided to create the woman of this coffee bar and make her hair a little abstract, and yeah, I tried to imitate those oranges. I punched them out from the book that I bought in this bookshop I talked about before. I have a process video for this page too. And yeah, for this I have also a process video. This is also made with a homemade structure paste and only white acrylic paint and black acrylic paint, and I added this picture of this Christmas decoration in the street, because this sweet lakritz has this star on the this logo too. Then one of my favorite places in Rome is Piazza del Popolo, and I wrote some facts here and tried to do a little acrylic a mixed acrylic paint here, and yeah, I tried out some techniques that I saw in art journals or mixed media journals, and I tried to do only some little things because I'm not an expert. I'm a beginner in mixed media and art journaling, and yeah, so that not the whole page is a disaster. I put it only those little dots here to test it out. This is a very special place about an artist who is called Dico, and he does his art with neon colors. I couldn't imitate this for this page because I only have had this children watercolors, but if you are in Rome, please go to this place and look at his art. He made art for every famous person you can imagine. There's Keanu Reeves and Morgan Freeman. He's incredible. He paints his pictures, and then he takes fire. He has a kind of plastic window over this canvas, and then he takes fire and he burns this whole thing. No, not the whole thing, but only the plastic, and it has a very interesting structure and style, and he's just amazing. And here's a little belly band. This you can get in my printable on Etsy too. Another picture from this flyer. Yeah, and then I tried to do this little thing. I hope you can imagine what this should be. I tried to imitate this man of Leonardo da Vinci, and then I put a little fatty girl in it, and I tried to imitate the circle and this proportions of this thing around, and then I put it her in, so but not like the original picture, and I wrote, Leonardo said you are perfect just the way you are, and I wanted to say that everyone is perfect as he is. And you can fit in this proportions that Da Vinci drawed on his painting. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? I can't explain this in English. Then I wrote some facts about Leonardo da Vinci. And this is the end of the journey. I have a process video of this page too. This was definitely my first attempt to do something like collage and mixed media and stenciling with things you have at home. Yeah, you know my channel, you know that I don't like to spend money for art supplies, and I know it's not perfect, but this ugly look, it's very, yeah, I think it fits very good to the Termini station when you go home, because there's a little bit, there it is a little bit ugly too. And yeah, these colors are not so bright, and yeah, my feelings were not bright too, because I had to go home, and yeah, so I left it like this. Is I was not so happy with this page in the beginning, but then I decided that it has to be like it is, because it's my first attempt. And now we are in the end, and as you can see, I yeah, had to do, I had to spend very, very much time to do this, and I think I can be a little bit proud of it. I don't know if you know my video about the Nepal journal I did a few months ago, and I thought, okay, this Nepal journal would be the biggest project you will ever do, and then I did this journal, and now I know it better. And yeah, I am very happy that I created this closure a little bit flexible, because this string, it's not so beautiful here, but when I open this little pearl, I can yeah, I can move it like this, and when I wanted it to be a little bit closer, I can do it with this hand. So yeah, then it's a little bit more compact, and if I would add some more informations, pictures or recipes or whatever, I can vary this length of it, so that it would be no problem when there is more stuff inside. So perhaps this is a little trick that you can do by yourself when you have a journal and you need a closure, and yeah, but you don't know the length of it, then you can do it like this, and yeah, you have a little bit more flexibility. Oh yeah, I have to thank you very, very much for watching. I think, I don't know how long this video will be, because I have to edit it, but I think, yeah, this is not only the biggest journal I've ever made, this is also the biggest video project on YouTube I have ever made, and I want to thank you for all the minutes you have watched, and for all, yeah, the attention you paid on my channel. I'm very happy that so many people watch my videos, and I've never expected that, that a channel that only uses homemade things and low-budget things, no expensive art supplies, can have over 500 subscribers until now. And yeah, I'm happy for every new subscriber, and for every minute you watch this, because I think there are so many things that destroy our environment that we can yeah, save a little bit of the planet when we use things that other people would throw away, like this papers from the restaurants, or yeah, nearly everything that is in this journal. Please excuse my very, very bad English. I had a very hard job to do this because I don't like myself talking on a video, and yeah, I'm not able to speak the perfect English, but yeah, I hope you enjoyed it. And yeah, I hope you will come back to this channel for more mixed media and art and junk journal stuff, and perhaps something like those little charms that you can do by yourself. And yeah, thanks so much for watching, and see you the next time. Bye bye.